captivated the nation, sending businesswoman turned con artist of the century, who swindled more than $40 million from family, friends, and clients before just batching to their.
Everyone has a theory. Everyone thinks they know what really happened. They don't. I'm not that person.
Oh, I think you are.
Wow, Wentworth star Kate Atkinson is telling Melissa Caddick's story in Underbelly Vanishing Act. And she joins us now from Perth. Kate, good morning to you. Congrats on the series. Tell us what you came to understand about Melissa Caddick in the process of filming this.
I guess there's a few layers to that process. There's a degree of research that you can do, but as you probably all know, there's, you know, the whole challenge of Melissa Caddick is it appeared no one knew her, including her nearest and dearest. So there are some actual facts, some events that you can pin your research on. And then my job is to then respond to the script that the writer, Matt Ford, has created. So there's then a fictitious drama built around those facts. And then I have to kind of find that person. So while everyone's mythologizing and scandalizing, there's a person there, and without excusing the behavior, I have to kind of try and find, you know, what drives those compulsions and those desires, and why would you want that or want to be that person? Or so there's, you know, there's very little we do know about the real Melissa, but we do know her actions to a degree and how they affected other people.
Is that hard as an actor to have somebody who's basically a blank slate like this, that, as you say, no one really knew or seemed to know her at all? She was, the con was so large with her. So do you then go, all right, I'll take from a whole bunch of different influences, or do you just go, like, I'll just create a new internal life for her?
It is a bit like that, and that's why I say, look, aside from the kind of factual research, my real source of material is the script, and it was kind of what attracted me to the project. I can say hand on heart, I'm not interested in being involved in something scandalous or that's going to attract negative attention or that's going to hurt people. So I really appreciated the writer's approach, and he's not pretending to know everything. In fact, if anything, one of the ideas that we explore in the show is that people are determined to believe what they want to believe. Once you've invested in a truth, doesn't matter how many facts someone puts in front of you, you will believe it. So what he actually does is toy with these different versions of what people want to believe. You know, people want to believe she's a villain. You know, someone wanted to believe that they could trust her, and some people want to believe she, you know, ended her own life. Some people wanted to believe she chopped off her own foot, or did someone else do it, or did she have some kind of underworld alliance in this? So there's kind of, alternative truths that we explore, I guess. But underneath that, I've still got to try and play person, and your job is to not really judge the person that you are playing, and when it appears that the person that you're playing has zero moral compass, it's a little bit of a juggling act. So I just kept going back to the script and working from that story, which I think is a really good one.
Well, meantime, a lot of our audience would know you as Vera Bennett from Wentworth, which has had enormous success as a series. What do you put that down to? Why do you think it's so loved?
Oh gosh, do you know what, I've been asked that question so many times, you'd think I'd have come up with a decent answer by now. I think, you know, it's interesting talking about, you know, moral ambiguities. I think people appreciate complex characters, that, you know, not everyone's heroic, not everyone's villainous. I think people really appreciate seeing a mostly all-female cast from all walks of life. There was a great deal of diversity in that cast. But I also think from a really basic level, people like watching people survive, like making mistakes and trying again, and you know, that really claustrophobic survival tactic that people had to use in that environment. And people just got really attached to those characters for all their faults.
Yeah, it's iconic. It's definitely iconic.
We're all terribly proud of it. It was a great bunch of people to work with, and it's just a bonus that everyone embraced it.
We're out of time, Kat, but congratulations on the new show, Underbelly Vanishing Act. This Sunday and Monday, it's going to be on 9. You enjoy your family over there in Perth, and we'll see you soon.
Thanks so much.
Thanks, Kate. Stay safe. When we return.